You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Johnson.
From the AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California, and streaming live on Ustream, this is AfterBuzz TV for Weeds. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest Weeds news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, picking up where the show leaves off, and the buzz continues, it's AfterBuzz TV for Weeds!
Yo, what up, AfterBuzzers? It's your boy DJ Jesse Janedy. I'm here in the booth. And I'm here with Mr. David. Mr. David Skiffletti. Hello. And we just got finished watching.
I was gonna clean my room until I got high.
Weeds. And we thought we'd treat you with a little introduction here. Ba-da-da-ba.
My room is still messed up. And I know why.
Why, man?
Yeah.
Because I got high.
Because I got high.
Alrighty, here we go, guys. Welcome to AfterBuzz TV, where we are here with all of your after show updates. Alright, so Weeds, before we get started,
yes,
thank you guys for joining us on iTunes. You guys are watching us on ustream.tv/AfterBuzz TV, but you can actually check us out if you miss us or if something's going on with your computer. Can't get video. Check us out on iTunes. I'm so excited. Pause. Vampire Diaries is in the back right now. Excuse me. Back to iTunes.
Season 2 on Blu-ray and DVD.
iTunes. Go to the iTunes store. Type in AfterBuzz TV. Weeds. Hit subscribe. It's free. Check us out every week. We're freaking awesome. Rock stars.
Rock stars.
If I must say. All right. So Weeds. Great episode last night.
Awesome.
Episode. So awesome that when we got to the end of it, I hardly wrote anything down because I was so sucked into the episode. And I couldn't believe it ended.
Shocked it was over, yeah. I was like, what? I could have sworn they could have fit like one more scene in there for us.
I felt like we needed one more.
Right? We need a like 2 minute scene or like 1 minute something. Come on.
But apparently we aren't getting an episode next week. So they were like, no, we really want you guys to come back.
I know, right? Leave us on a cliffhanger.
Give me more. All right. So the intro this week, let's talk about it.
Back to Britney.
Now, always back to Britney.
Intro is good.
The intro. Kind of wanted it to go something along the lines of a computer, because the computer was stolen last
right.
week. This title was called System Overload. Figured they would tie that in somehow.
Yeah.
But they brought in, it was Doug, and he was holding little paper signs up that said Weeds created by. And then what did it say at the end?
It said duty, and then it said sorry, and then it said begin.
Clever, because we've never seen an actual character from the show in the intro like that.
Yeah, it was nice. I mean, it was fun.
They've
fun
never
to,
been
like,
this
watch.
Creative, I don't
think. No, I don't think so either.
Like, they're really going all out.
But they're coming back. Like, not all of the openers have made sense with the episodes, but
right. now
things are starting to, like, come full circle.
Well, I don't know, because I kind of want... It makes me want to go back to see...
All the other
Some
openers.
Because I remember one of my favorite ones. It was, and actually now I'm thinking about it, was season 5.
Mm-hmm.
And it was when they were doing the whole like drug trafficking and whatever. They were on a bus and this woman sat down on the bus and she moved whatever was on the seat over, and on a carton of cigarettes, it said Weeds.
Mm-hmm.
And I would have never recognized that because there was so much going on, but it was just a little detail in there. And then as she opened up the cigarette pack and pulled one of the cigarettes out where the writing would be on a cigarette that created by.
Oh.
I was like, it's really, you know what I mean? Very clever.
Very clever.
These guys. All right, so last week we... Pouncy House was... David's getting distracted watching Teen Mom.
I mean, I can't.
I mean...
Teen Mom in the background. I mean,
all right, Pouncy House. Refresh our memory.
Okay. So last week, we found out that Emma, who played by Michelle Trachtenberg, is the head honcho at Pouncy House. And they came in... Silas and Emma went on a date, and they came in overnight, stole the brain from Silas's business and his... everything out of the business, and they flipped the Copenhagen bike shop upside down. So everything was on the ceiling. The bicycles, the lights were coming up from the floor, the pictures were flipped.
Very creative, very cool.
Very shocking to walk into your business and everything is either gone or on the ceiling.
Right. So before we get into that part of the story, NYPD calls Nancy.
Yes.
And he wants to talk to her because, as we saw last week, Shane was arrested. So Nancy went in and met Shane's mentor. I guess we'll call him his mentor.
I would say that's his mentor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who was concerned because Shane stole information about Pouncy House, and he's kind of feeling that, you know, Shane might be involved with this drug deal going on.
Yeah, because he said that I started asking him questions about Pouncy House and he got defensive and he stopped answering questions.
Right.
So he has like some sort of inkling that something's going on with Shane, but he doesn't really know exactly what.
So Nancy does her little canoodling and gets her way into the jail cell basically to talk to Shane.
She's so good with men.
She's amazing.
Like, not so great with other women. But
well,
she just
very
has like
threatening with other women.
Yeah,
if you notice.
She is. She has like a very like I'm the alpha female.
Right.
No matter what room she walks into, but with men, she's very good at always getting her way.
Drinks a lot of coffee.
She drinks a shit ton of coffee.
I think she has a coffee every episode.
Every scene, she's holding a coffee cup. She goes to see Dimitri in the beginning.
Yep.
And she has an iced coffee. But
and
she
does
have
switch.
Hair.
She
and
does switch from iced coffee
to hot
coffee.
Coffee.
Yeah.
And then she, from Dimitri's, goes to the NYPD and has a smaller hot coffee.
Yeah, loves her caffeine. Keeps her going.
Always drinks coffee.
Like
all the time, all day long.
So basically, she kind of makes her little connection with the NYPD officer.
Mm-hmm.
We'll say that. Gets Shane out there. He apologizes and says that he can handle everything that's going on. All Nancy really wants for Shane, I mean, it makes sense because she did go away for 3 years and she took the blame for Shane.
Yeah, she said that she spent 3 years in jail so that he didn't have to.
Right. So, you know, I understand her wanting to, I thought it was a really clever line of, my dream is for you to go to college. She said, save that dream for
Stevie.
Stevie. She said, no, that's reality. You going to college is a dream. So she wants better for Shane. She knows he's already in a fucked up situation.
Yeah, to say the least.
And it's good that she brought the name Stevie got brought up because it's almost kind of like Nancy was kind of getting a little wild there within the past couple episodes.
Yeah, we haven't really.
I mean,
hasn't
where's
been
the
much
lawyer?
Going on.
Martin Short hasn't come back.
That's right.
And, you know,
it's been like 4 episodes, I want to say, since we've even heard of Stevie.
Mm-hmm. All right. Doug gets a visit from his coworker who brings him Venezuelan cigars, which were rolled by 20 children.
So fancy, Venezuelan cigars.
Yeah. And basically a congratulations for putting a stop to the SEC trying to threaten them.
And if you notice, inside the box of cigars, there was like a little placket which was something that he told the SEC was, all I can think about is your wife and a horse.
Yeah.
And I don't remember him saying that. What was he even talking about? Where he said that all I can think about is your wife and a horse.
I have no.
Do you remember?
I don't.
It was one of his threats.
I don't remember.
One of his better moments, I think.
He's insane. Rocket Man.
I'm Rocket Man.
How are you? So then the SEC secretary comes in, and she basically says, well, no, I want to review your files. Thanks a lot, you assholes, because now I'm being pushed to...
spreadsheet duties.
Right. So basically what she's trying to do is make sure, all right, since we're involved with you, we don't want to be involved with the shady part of you. So she's going to review all the files, which was interesting because she, as she sat at the desk, she pulled out the wooden owls.
That we
which
saw.
Was the intro from last week.
Was that last week?
For Cats, Cats, Cats.
Was it?
Yes, because remember, we tied it to them always being watched.
Being watched. That's right.
I
couldn't remember if it was last week or if it was like 3 or 4 episodes ago.
No. It was it was either last week or the week before. It definitely wasn't a few weeks ago.
Okay.
But
yeah, she pulls out all the owls, puts them on her desk, and if you noticed, on her scarf
was an owl.
She had an owl brooch keeping it together.
Okay, the owls are kind of scary. Stop that.
I like owls. Owls
They're
are cute.
Cool. Okay. Are they from Russia?
Yeah. Yes. You can only find owls in Russia, by the way. Just so you know.
All right. It wasn't last week, because last week was the little person on the bike.
Yes.
And I thought it should have been a Russian bear.
You're a mess.
All right, guys. If you're out there, you watched the episode last night, make sure you call us and give us some of your opinions. 424-256-1729.
Or just call us and tell us to give up.
Or just call and talk to us.
Give us a shout out.
I want to know, do you smoke weed? You know, what are some stories that you have?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that would be awesome to hear.
I mean, can you compare to Nancy Baldwin? I want to know. Our viewers want to know.
Can you?
Our listeners. I mean, I've never... sold drugs. I've partaken.
You've never sold drugs?
Yeah.
What?
I've partaken in the experience of them. However, selling them, no. I can't say I've had the privilege. All right, so basically the SEC lady is going to be a part. I have a feeling she's going to end up working for them.
I have a feeling that she's going to end up working for Doug because he said that he was looking for a new
secretary.
And so she's going through his files. And I mean, for sure she's going to end up working there. Otherwise, they wouldn't have brought her back in.
Right.
Under the guise of, wanting to look over their investment. And so this way, it's a way for them to keep an eye on their money.
Which now they're kind of screwed because...
Right.
Homeboy from last week, who was trying to bring Nancy on a vacation, the CEO...
Vacation.
Vacation.
It was a permanent vacation. Yeah. Yes.
Basically, took a whole bunch. He didn't take petty cash. He took
cash.
So they're kind of screwed. Cash, but cash. I think Doug's gonna step up, and I think Doug's gonna do really well this season.
This season, I think so. I mean, he's very good with money, as we've seen from previous seasons. He's very smart. He's book smart, I would say, but he's mentally ill.
Yeah, he's a little challenged. But the thing about Doug is, as much as he screws up and you just watch him fall and trip and it's just like, ooh, it's real ugly, he always comes through in the end.
He always comes back.
So, go get him, Doug.
Get him good.
Emma. We see Emma this episode.
Emma.
Silas is
so
really torn apart.
Not likable.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know if she's supposed to be likable. I doubt she is.
No, I don't think so.
But
because I don't like her one bit. Actually, it makes me kind of hate Michelle Trachtenberg.
I know, that's what I'm saying. And I like Michelle Trachtenberg.
I mean, I liked her in Harriet the Spy.
That was
Yep, it was. I liked
15,
her.
Maybe
I liked
17,
her in Buffy.
20 years ago.
She was in Buffy.
She was on
from
Buffy.
Seasons 5 to 6, I liked her. Season
she was
seven,
on season 7, though.
She upset me in season 7.
Why? Because she got snooty.
She got snooty with Buffy.
And no one cared about her anymore.
The only person who protected her was Buffy. And
the only person who protected Dawn was Buffy.
Yes. Who else? Right. Anyways, like this episode
Willow.
Of Weeds.
Willow looked after her.
First of all, season 6.
She went nuts and tried to kill everybody.
Right, okay.
I know.
And
okay.
Who protected Dawn? Buffy. End of story. David, please.
Buffy killed herself to save Dawn.
Yes.
I mean, I get it.
Because otherwise she could have thrown Dawn in there and end the story.
Should have thrown Dawn in there.
We would have been back to season 3. All right, back to Weeds.
Back to Weeds. Sorry, y'all.
Sorry, y'all.
Sorry, y'all.
So Andy and Silas stop Emma walking on the street, and Silas tries to... I don't know what he was trying to do. Like,
he was trying to intimidate her.
Really, Silas, you're the most non-intimidating person. Even if you try to look mad, it just looks sexy.
Oh, really?
But you know what I mean? Like, did you see him, like, trying to yell at her? He was like,
I know.
He had his eyes squinted. And it was just like, you look like a puppy dog. Like,
no one
is intimidated by that. Like, she'll punch you in your face.
It's true. It's very
and
true.
And you'll just stand there with your mouth open like, done. You know?
That so made no sense to me.
Andy is getting upset and grabs a
nail gun.
And puts it to Emma's face on the streets of New York.
I know, that's super dangerous.
And nobody cared, nobody stopped.
Nobody cared. And he was yelling, oh, I'm going to kill somebody.
Okay, that part, I believe nobody would
listen
to him.
I mean...
But the nail gun thing, I feel like somebody would be like...
I don't know.
That doesn't look
right. It was on Columbia, in like the Columbia area,
mm-hmm.
which is what, 116th on the west side?
Yeah. But
that's Harlem.
Right.
No, that's normal for Harlem.
Right,
I mean, come on, that's very commonplace.
Not for a white man to be walking around with a staple gun to a white woman.
Yeah, of course.
No.
Of course, yes it is.
I don't believe
it's completely normal.
Don't
Everyone would be like, stupid white people. That crazy white man.
Stupid white bitch.
That crazy white man's gonna shoot that crazy white bitch in the head
so
with a nail gun.
So he puts her in the van.
Let's watch.
You will never believe what I saw today. Watch this YouTube video.
Exactly.
Oh.
Hide your kids. Okay.
Hide your mother effing kids. So Andy basically takes Emma captive.
Rightfully so.
Right, and he's going crazy.
Batshit.
Like, literally. Pulls mm-hmm. her in. Brings her back to the lair.
To the bike shop. To the lair. Because he's like an evil mastermind.
To the Copenhagen lair.
He has like an underground village of where his cave is.
They are bats. It's upside down.
Lair.
And basically holds the gun to her face as she's trying to unscrew everything from the ceiling.
With a regular screwdriver, by the way,
yes.
And like a chair. He's like, here, get on this chair. Here's the screwdriver.
But he made sense. I would have done the same thing.
What I would have done too.
Like, yeah, you're not going to use the power drill, actually. We'll be here all night.
We could be here all night. I have got nowhere to go.
Nowhere, because this is where I'm supposed to be.
This is my life, okay? I ain't got shit place to be.
You screwed it up. So I like that. I like that scene. He said that she was just going to clean up his life because he's done nothing wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And Nancy and Silas have to figure their own problems out.
Right. Which I think ended up being the worst thing to do.
As far as what?
Well, Andy tells Nancy to fix her life and he tells Silas to fix his life. So they both take the initiative to solve their problem, but their problem has to do with each other, like directly involves with each other.
Right. So rather than figuring out their problem
together, they're both like, I'm going to figure this out on my own.
And it's going to get really messy next.
Really quick. It's going to get real messy real quick.
I did see a redeemer in the previews, which we'll talk about. So maybe it won't get that messy.
We'll see.
We'll see.
We'll see about that.
Because it is Weeds. So
it is Weeds. I mean, something's got to happen.
So Nancy walks in and realizes, okay, Andy's gone crazy. He needs to leave.
And but everyone has a key to the bike shop
except
Andy.
Which doesn't make sense because how did you get in the bike shop?
It was probably open.
Yeah, probably.
How did they get into the bike shop to turn everything upside down? It was, he probably left it open.
Because he didn't have a key.
Because he didn't have a key.
To lock up. So, yeah, Nancy kind of takes over. And this is where I love Nancy, because she... They start getting in the conversation about, you know, things that the Botwins have that Pouncy Hounce doesn't have. And
right. Pouncy I had a hard time understanding what she was saying.
What Nancy was saying?
Yeah, did you catch that?
All right. Overall, Nancy is saying, you, basically that Emma is her at a younger age.
Right. Like, so, 20 years ago.
And basically saying, like, you're doing the things that I'm doing now, older in life. Because I've gone through the experience of life. You haven't even experienced it. You're where I am without going through all the shit. Nancy went through hell to be in the position she's in now.
Right.
This girl is just like, no, I'm in a smart little bitch and I have my shit together and I'm going to put it all together. Rather than learning how to cop out of things. Like you saw, like, she's just walking on the streets like she's in, like, it's no big deal. Like, basically, the way, you know, and at the end, Nancy said, there's a whore and then there's a cheap whore.
Mm-hmm.
And Nancy says, I'm a whore, because I believe Nancy was referring to herself as a whore because she does sleep around with different people.
But for a reason.
It's for a reason, and it's never out of just pure lust. There's always something that needs to get done out of it.
Mm-hmm.
This girl... She even said, I wasn't going to screw you over. I mean, I was going to screw you over, period. I didn't mean to sleep with you. That just happened.
Right. Just got caught up in the moment.
Right. Caught up in the moment. My nuts. sorry.
What?
I just got really upset with her.
With who?
Michelle Trash.
With Emma?
What slut?
Nancy's also, you know, coming to the fact of, you don't know what you're getting yourself into. You think, like, oh, I'm in school for law. I'm going to be able to pull one over everyone's head. If anyone tries to come at me, I know all the legal things to say.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when Nancy said, that's actually when Nancy said, there's a whore and then there's a cheap whore. And it all clicked in her head. And she said, you don't have everything that we have. And Nancy walked out.
Well, it's kind of true.
Well, I know, because the purpose is the Botwins have a cover-up. They're a family.
Right.
And...
But they also have a shit ton of connections in all the wrong places.
Wrong or right?
Well, both. All the right and the wrong places. I mean, if she wanted to, she could have... I mean, Dimitri offered. He's got a whole bunch of friends at the base who are bored, doing nothing.
Who wanna
start some shit.
Yeah.
With some teenagers.
Right. Kind of would have been interesting.
I mean,
that
would have been really interesting to see. But instead, she goes to the cops. Directly to the cops.
Smart idea.
Very smart.
And we kind of predicted this a few weeks back, saying that, except we thought Shane was going to be the one to do it all. But Nancy is too quick with that brain of hers. She went bam, bam, bam in her head.
Very quick, and was like talking to him about his kid. Getting to know him on a personal level and been like, oh, I know where you've been. I've been there before. I was there with Silas.
And now she's worried about Silas because he's involved with Pouncy House because he likes Emma.
Right.
And then she starts crying and being upset and, you know.
Conniving.
Love her.
Sneaky, sneaky little hoe.
Love her.
I mean, yeah. I mean.
Basically, she
goddess.
As DJ Behar. Our dear host here at AfterBuzz would say, goddess.
Goddess.
And if anyone is.
If anyone is, Nancy Botwin is. Like,
why? Because goddesses can make shit happen.
Right? And she would do anything for her children and has done anything for her children.
Have you sold yourself over the border? Nancy has.
Yes.
Multiple times.
Have you gone to jail so that your son who killed someone
doesn't?
Nancy has. I mean, there is
and then
nothing
over,
she wouldn't do.
And then screw over the police to get the tape back of the killing.
Like
Nancy has.
There's nothing she wouldn't do.
So, within all this, Nancy goes and basically breaks a deal with the officer in that you don't get Silas in trouble because she pinned it all on Silas.
Mm-hmm. No, but I didn't think she said.
Well, saying that he's
saying
involved
that he's involved with her, like dating her,
but also involved with Pouncy House, because that's when he said, "Make sure he's not there,
right?
And he shouldn't be getting involved with drugs at such a young
mm-hmm.
age."
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So either or, she's just, you know, clearing everything up from under the bush and saying, look, even if he is involved, I don't want him in trouble. That's why she said, he said, do you want some help? She said, well, who am I going to come to? You? I don't want my son being arrested. So the deal is, we get Emma. You guys are free to walk. Almost wish something came out in Nancy, because I feel like it's going to backfire in Nancy's face.
It definitely, it's definitely going to.
I just don't want Nancy to get in trouble. I don't mind if it backfires, but I don't
she's
know how
gonna
Nancy's
going to
get out of that.
No, she's going to get in trouble because what she did.
Which will hopefully lead us to season 8.
Yeah. Oh, there you go. What she did was go to the cops, but what she doesn't know is that she left Shane with Emma.
Silas.
Thank you. Excuse me. Silas. She left Silas with Emma, and they start discussing how they're going to work everything out. And Silas is telling Emma that they have one thing that Pouncy House doesn't have, and that was the better weed.
Well, see.
And so they're now going to, and she has the technology and the clients.
This is where the creator was kind of funny with how he did that. He said, we have one thing that you don't have. And they went back and referenced the weed. But mm-hmm. as soon as he said, we have one thing that you don't have, they shot to Nancy.
Right.
And to me, that's really what they have. They have somebody who will put herself on the line every time.
Right. That's true.
And who, like she said to Emma, I've been through it all. I know how to do this.
Mm-hmm. I've done what you're doing.
Don't F with me like you don't know who I am.
It's true. It's very true.
Like, this little old white woman.
What little old white woman?
I'm only saying old as a
term of endearment?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you referring to Nancy?
To Nancy.
Okay.
This poor woman.
You can say this skinny white bitch.
This skinny white bitch has screwed over major drug dealers,
mm-hmm.
screwed over Spanish cartels,
mm-hmm.
Mexican cartels.
Yeah.
And come out of it stronger than ever. Screwed over the system multiple times.
She's had cover businesses before.
Every season.
Mm-hmm.
And here she is winning.
Well, not yet, but
she's always winning.
She will.
She's Nancy Ball.
She will come out on top eventually.
Yes.
She's Nancy Botwin.
So that's where we have. That's where we're at. So I thought that was, and I thought that was really cool as far as the creator shooting to the picture of her after he said that.
Yeah.
Yes, they do have the better weed, but I mean, at
I mean
this
that's
point,
what he was referring to, but it was very clever for the editing and the director to have put Nancy in that position. I didn't even catch that. Thank you for pointing it out to me. Don't cut me up.
So then they come into a deal. Here, I won't cut you. Tell them about the deal.
I don't know. You do it. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Emma and Silas. Silas tries to fix the problem by, which is so dumb to me, and it's such a typical, like, you're thinking with your dick.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. For sure.
You're going to team up with the girl who screwed you over?
How do you know she's not going to screw you over again? Because she will.
I mean, so, clearly, thinking with his male genitals, says, all right. I don't know exactly what the percentage is that they said.
No, I mean, they don't even give us that.
But basically, they're going to work together. And how they left the scene was, well, I guess that was in the
No, the final scene was Silas
giving a call to Nancy saying that I took care of our problem, give me a call back. And then he gets off the phone and he's at Pouncy House headquarters.
Ridiculous.
Ridiculous. And then they zoom into a balloon that says celebrate.
Yeah.
And then it cut out and we were both like, oh, no, one more, just a second longer.
We're going. So any last thoughts of the episode before we go to a commercial and come back with predictions?
I don't think so.
Andy's kind of getting washy for me.
What do you mean?
I mean, I guess he's there for comedic purposes now.
I mean, he's become like the comedic relief.
But it's funny because that's what Doug used to be, and now Doug actually has a storyline.
Yeah, Doug has a very strong storyline.
And Andy's storyline has totally, completely, like,
Well, they sort of put him on the back burner for the whole season, actually.
Why do you think that? You think maybe he's just been riding strong the past few seasons? And
well, because really I weird. Think it's more to do with the fact that there has to be somebody in the family who is like the conflict within the family, who doesn't want to be part of the drug business anymore, who's sick of running from the law, who's sick of moving every year, you know? So he's been, for this season at least, trying to start over.
Right.
So he has his business, his Copenhagen wheel business. And as we saw in this episode, he's fed up of fixing everyone else's problems. And so he's going to fix his own problem, his current problem at hand, and move on with his life.
Although I feel, in the very end, he's going to be the one to save everybody.
Of course, because that's what he does.
That is what he does.
But that he's like sick of it, but he's going to have to.
But he is kind of going really crazy.
He's going nuts. But that's what
also
I think Justin Kirk as the actor shines.
Yeah. As crazy, crazy.
As crazy. Cry, cry. Cry, cry. Okay.
Also, before we go to a commercial, a little tiny plot that we left out was Nancy had gone to Dimitri because Dimitri called her, and he wanted to give her 60 pounds of new weed that he found. And he wanted to team up. So I'm wondering if they're going to team up eventually, because she kind of has to.
No, she doesn't. She told him that I don't owe you anything.
Right.
You're my dealer. I buy weed from you. Occasionally we have sex, but other than that, this is a business arrangement. Because now she has other people to sleep with, you know?
Yeah, but she also did give her the
She
ultimatum.
Can't spread the puna on all over the city. I mean, she could, but she might get tired.
It's Nancy. It's she Nancy. Already is tired.
I know. She's exhausted. That's why she's drinking all that coffee. Right.
She's got to keep her ass awake. She's got to keep the punan awake. All right, so we're going to shoot over to a commercial break. When we come back, we'll give you guys some predictions.
Want to find out what the AfterBuzz is about?
Janice is a drama queen.
This is the divide that is going to carry the series.
Give us a call. 424-256-1729. 256-1729.
This television, and they want it to be as dramatic as possible.
I mean, it's Shakespearean.
You never know what goes on behind closed doors.
Find out why AfterBuzz TV is the number one source for after-show content.
Now, in the eyes of Jimmy, Nucky is a villain.
424-256-1729. 424-256-1729.
I mean, who would you guys rather hear that from? Your husband or your best friend?
The wig will come out.
When the TV show is over, get your AfterBuzz on.
There it is. The creepy
and now,
predictions music.
Your AfterBuzz TV predictions.
All right, so for next week, or it might be 2 weeks.
It's
from
2 weeks.
It's 2 weeks.
I wanted you to rewind it so you could see where it says.
All right, so
a new episode in 2 weeks.
We're not getting a new episode next week. We're getting, we have to wait.
A repeat.
A full whole week with no weeds. But it looks promising to be a really good episode.
It looks really good. It looks like they go on vacation to the Hamptons.
Yep.
See, all new in 2 weeks. And what I'm assuming is Nancy's going to find a whole new breed of client.
Yeah, that's what it looked like.
Right? She's going to be finding a new way to market her business.
She had like the cute little wrap present and all that.
Right?
With
the rich, like, upper crust New Yorkers.
Right. So,
that aside,
we also have something going on with Silas and Emma getting an argument, and he says deals off.
Or she, I think she says deals off.
And then we see
Emma getting carried away by the police.
Which at first time I thought that she was getting pulled away in the bike shop, but it actually is being pulled away in Pouncy House.
Mm-hmm.
So I wonder what she's going to say.
That's where it's going to get messy.
Yeah.
Because I think she's going to get arrested, and then she's going to talk about Nancy and rat her out. And then I think she's going to have to start sleeping with the detective.
No.
I think so.
Nancy?
Yeah, not Emma.
Hey, she's a young Nancy.
No. Emma's going to get written off really soon.
I hope so.
I hope so.
Her character just...
I don't like her.
Her character just didn't do it for me this season. And still no hope of a season 8. We're still in limbo.
No word?
No word.
We haven't heard anything? No word on them being filming anything? Or
nope. So.
So I guess we'll see what happens at the end of this season.
Maybe they'll pull an Entourage and come out with a Weeds movie.
Oh, God. But Entourage. I could do a Weeds movie because they'd be ending on a high note. Entourage has been on the air for so long. And that show, from what I hear, has just gone downhill in the past few seasons.
Well, maybe the movie can bring him back up. But I would be okay with a Weeds movie is because we watch a half hour every week, and we just want so much more.
And we want more, yeah. It was like with Sex and the City.
I feel like an hour and a half of Weeds could...
Or 2.5 hours.
Do it justice. Really do it justice.
Yeah, I mean, in all honesty, a Weeds movie would be incredible. If they didn't do another season.
Right.
If they do another season, I don't think they would
need
to do a movie.
They can end next season. I just need one more.
I would prefer them to end this season and then have a movie.
No.
Yes.
It's too soon.
It's not
because too next soon. Season we're going to watch it and we're going to still want a movie.
Probably.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so that's...
But I like going to the movies.
I love going to the movies too, but I just can't hear that it's the end yet.
Well, we don't know yet. We still have next week, and you haven't told me what you think's going to happen next week, so I want to hear what your thoughts are. I stumped you.
Yeah, because I think Nancy's going to get outed, but... I think Shane is going to be the one to save the day. I think Shane's going to make the whole... I feel like the detective's going to feel for the Botwins, and they're going to gain him on their side. Stronger than he already is.
Interesting.
Just a thought.
I could totally see that happening. That's why I think she's going to start sleeping with him.
Because I believe Nancy would totally go like, I was only selling drugs because, you know, we needed a way to get by. I was in a shelter home, like...
Halfway house.
Yeah.
I mean...
I think that's where we're going to go.
I think so, too.
I'll be happy with that.
I would not be happy for Nancy.
No.
I'd feel really bad for Nancy.
But
you know, she's got to do what she's got to do.
I think the detective looks at Shane like a son because Shane looks up to him.
Right.
Whereas
I think so
his
too.
Real son doesn't.
I think that's his stepson. I don't even think that's his real son.
Well, his only type of son.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's all he got really. So thank you guys for joining us.
Thank you.
David, thank you for joining me, sir. Until not next week, but the week after.
Week after.
The week following, September 13th.
No.
Yeah. Believe it or not.
Is it really?
It is.
Oh my God.
September 13th, we'll be back. So have a happy Labor Day, people.
Yeah.
Also,
same to you.
Hey, if you don't have anything to do tonight, check out AfterBuzz TV. We have the A-List New York coming up at 8 o'clock.
And Pretty Little Liars at 9.
And with Tyler Blackburn,
who plays Caleb.
And Brandon
Roberts, I think, who plays Lucas.
In studio.
In studio, y'all. And a phone interview.
Yes. I had the pleasure of speaking to Julian Morris, who plays Ren. So it's a boys' night out.
Boys' night out.
With the ladies of Pretty Little Liars.
And me.
And me,
David Scifoletti.
So until next time, guys. Peace.
Bye.
From producers Kevin Undergaro and Phil Svitek, engineer DJ Jesse Janedy, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. If you have questions or comments, be sure to buzz us at info@afterbuzztv.com. And you can find us on Facebook or follow us on Twitter by searching for AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.